What up, I do? Today's video, we're going to find out why this old-fashioned fertiliser is key for a healthy lawn. We're going to see how it's harvested and the method they use to turn it from this into what we would use in our lawns using cold-pressed extraction. I'm going to be visiting Ballyliffin Golf Course, which was home to the Irish Open in 2018, to find out exactly how they use the seaweed and why it is so important. I'll be talking to a leading scientist called Dr. Deborah Cox, and Deborah will be talking through the use of seaweed, not only on grass, but why you'd want to use seaweed if you're going to be sowing seeds, or how you can use it to improve the plants in your garden.
I'm Mark here from Ocean Knowledge. Today we're going to talk you through the seaweed harvesting. So the seaweed is harvested in low tide. The tidal movement is every 6 hours, so there's a low tide every 12 hours. Harvesters generally harvest along a shoreline, or else they're harvesting out on a small island. Cut with a small knife or hook. The most important thing with seaweed harvesting is to leave the growth on the plant. So we leave 6 to 8 inches of the plant on the rock at all times. This allows the seaweed to regrow within 3 to 5 years. This roasting knowledge is one of the most important factors in the seaweed harvesting. It allows us to harvest in a site today, and we know we can go back to that seaweed harvesting site within that time frame, 3 to 5 years. Once the seaweed lands on the truck, it's loaded up onto this tray here for the boys to hand pick. Every seaweed, every kilo of seaweed that we land to the factory is hand inspected to pick out any species of seaweed that we don't want, stones, shells, to wash off any sand or dirt that's in the seaweed. It's moved along and it's washed here now with fresh water. So once the seaweed is hand inspected and washed outside, it's then moved on a conveyor on into the factory. And this is also hand inspected here. So once they're happy here, it moves onto a conveyor. This here conveyor is weighing the seaweed on the screen. So once the boys have 5 kilos on this conveyor, the conveyor then moves automatically into the first tank down below. It's stored in the tank for 10 minutes, continuously chopping up and cutting in the tank. So the next stage in the process after the chopping of the seaweed and the cutting of the seaweed is pumped into this here tank. This tank here is under vacuum. This gives the product that little bit more extraction, extracting more nutrients, carbohydrates from the product. This is a decanting machine or a separation machine. The product is pumped along in here and spinned at a high speed. So the liquid is spinned off the solid product. And this in turn separates the soluble fibers from the insoluble fibers. Once the product is finished in the separation process, the insoluble fibers move along the belt and into the storage bag here. We have a local customer base that purchase this product offers for fertiliser. All the seaweed liquid extract is pumped along through this filter press. It all is through this filter shock, which is all less than 200 micron. Once the product is filtered and cleaned, it's then pumped across to this final storage tank. In this final storage tank, we add a food grade preservative to give that product the shelf life required. It's then pumped along this packing line where we fill into 10 litre bag and box. This is our main packaging. You can see here our new packaging of the bag and box which we introduced this year. It's a lot more environmentally friendly than our traditional jerry can that we've used in the past. Each pallet that we ship out in bag and box contains 1,000 litres. Each pallet has a reduction of 39% plastic in each pallet. This product is heading for Sweden. We also ship all over Europe. We ship to Asia, Australia, and then we ship to both East and West Coast in America. We also service our local markets here in Ireland and the UK.
Today, I'm at Ballyliffin Golf Course to find out how the seaweed is used.
My name's Andy Robertson, link superintendent here at Ballyliffin Golf Club. I've been here for 25 years now. Been greenkeeping for quite a bit longer than that. Started off up in the north of Scotland, went down to Sunningdale in England, did 7 years in Sunningdale, and came here for a year's work, and I'm still here yet. We're on here in the 12th green. We have fescue greens here, which we run on a program. It's a traditional greenkeeping program. I prefer the old natural ways. We have good results with that, and it's a basic thing. Iron sulfate, sulfate ammonia, and seaweed. Three products. We spray for 6 months a year with iron sulfate, sulfate ammonia, and seaweed. Winter months, just iron sulfate and seaweed. Seaweed in is a soil conditioner and to kelp, keep the root structure good. Turf is good, strong, good sward density. That's what people want. When you're taking people to play golf, they want good greens.
I am Declan Gallagher, Managing Director of Ocean Knowledge. One of the first questions I'm generally asked when I travel is, what's the difference between seaweed, algae and kelp? And for us, they're the exact same thing. We harvest and use a brown seaweed called Ascophyllum nodosum. Ascophyllum nodosum grows along the west coast of Ireland and in the northern hemisphere. And what makes the Ascophyllum nodosum unique is the environment that it grows naturally within. It grows 50% of its life in the water and 50% of its life out of the water. And over the last hundreds of years, for the plant to be able to survive, it had to build up a very strong immune system. So Ascophyllum nodosum contains high levels of carbohydrates, amino acids, micro and macronutrients, as well as vitamins, all of which are fundamental for the plant to be able to survive in a stressful growing environment. What is seaweed? And I've used seaweed and sometimes don't see the results that I was hoping to see from seaweed. But you got to remember that seaweed is a product that's high in carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are very, very important for the plant to produce energy. And for us, the plant is a living organism. The more energy we give the plant, the healthier the plant becomes. When we talk about a healthy plant produces good density, it produces good color, and more importantly for us, starts to develop a strong and healthy root system. One of the things that people don't know about seaweed is seaweed not only helps the plant, but it also helps the ground that the plant grows in. For us, many of our customers feed the grass, but they never feed the ground that the grass is growing in. So when you apply our product and spray it onto your grassland, 60% of the nutrients, which is carbohydrates, amino acids, vitamins, and micro macronutrients, absorbed by the leaf. But the remaining 40% that's not absorbed by the leaf is washed off the leaf down into your sand and soil profile. And down into your sand and soil profile, you're putting carbohydrates. Carbohydrates benefit and feed beneficial microbacteria. That beneficial microbacteria then start to break down all the dead organic matter. And for us, that's massively important. When talking about Ascophyllum nodosum, 62% of the dry matter within fresh Ascophyllum is carbohydrates. And carbohydrates are the group of elements which is most important to turf grass. Because when we talk about grass, grass is a living organism, and like any living organism, you've got to give it energy. And when we talk about spraying our product or liquid extract onto grass or turf grass, we're basically applying high quantities of carbohydrates. And then what the plant does is it stores them carbohydrates. And when it comes under stress, whether it's drought stress, salinity stress, shade stress, it can convert them carbohydrates into energy. By applying high quantities of carbohydrates to the plant then stores them carbohydrates and can convert them into energy. So when, for example, we talk about drought stress, the first symptom that most people will see when their plant comes under drought stress is they will start to notice a reduction in chlorophyll, which obviously means the plant is losing the ability to be able to produce colour. When we look at seaweed, the plant then will take them carbohydrates, convert them into energy, and can use that energy to produce chlorophyll.
Today, I'm at Beaver Park Golf Course in Belfast, Northern Ireland, to find out not only how the seaweed affects grass, but also grass seed and other plants.
My name is Deborah and I am Managing Director of Lagan Valley Scientific based in Northern Ireland. And here we're at Beaver Park and I'm going to be talking to you a little bit about seaweeds. So when we think about applying a seaweed product and why we might want to do this, one of the main reasons is root growth. So when you apply a seaweed-based product, one of the things that we see after a period of time, after a series of applications, is acceleration of growth in the root system. One of the reasons this happens is because seaweed products contain what's called auxins. These are plant hormones, and these can actually help the plants to help themselves. When we think about applying a seaweed-based product, it's important to think ahead of time. Why? Well, because abiotic stress is a major factor that leads to thinning out of the sward surface. And so if we want to think about preventing that, we can apply seaweeds all through the year in advance of the turf suffering from cold stress or heat stress. So another thing that can really help when it comes to applying seaweed is that it really helps with the evenness of germination and to accelerate growth during the early phases of growing. So this gives a bit of an advantage to these plants because when they're very young, they're quite vulnerable to pests and diseases. And so one way of mitigating that is to encourage growth during the early phases of growing. So we've just come over to the clubhouse and just to mention that you can apply seaweeds as a foliar spray or a root drench. The difference between these two is obviously how it's applied and in what volume. So a foliar spray would typically be on the surface of the plants and a root drench is most of that product going into the soil. Both can benefit the plants, and what we know is that just like in turf, you can very subtly change the microbial profile in the root zone. So what happens is that the roots become occupied by organisms called endophytes. These live inside of the roots. These can really help with things like nutrient acquisition and extending the roots through hypha. These are small little strands that extend from the roots, and they can really help with anchorage and recruitment of water. So biostimulants and seaweeds in particular can really help with water use efficiency across your course and help you meet environmental policies that you have in place. It's really important to think about incorporating a program into an ornamental plant's lifespan early because it can help create a more robust root system. As well as that, it can help with the onset of flowering and enhance the number of buds. So if you have a plant which is maybe struggling, you can actually help it ahead of summertime when you would expect the flowering to be peaking. And this can also help because during the heat of summer, abiotic stress will rise. And so incorporating a plan that includes seaweed products early will actually help that plant be primed against that abiotic stress before that time occurs.